definitely climb on that. Alright, this is the last one there is, right?
This is our grand
two final ones. We got two final ones to get back in the lodge.
Are you alright, Gordon?
Yeah, I've gone up.
What?
Suspense. What if they do night runs? Storm coming too. The wind's gonna be pushing us a little bit more.
Damn.
Shame that you guys don't have a clock on the bottom. Now,
when y'all start braking at the bottom, drop your legs. So that'll help slow you down to more wind resistance.
Oh,
the way he did it is actually important because this extension off the platform, you sit down that harness too early, you're going to spank the baby on the edge there.
Oh.
And it's going to hurt. Like that diving board move, except this doesn't give at all. You can't take a break. Look at that, a half mile to go. So, now the line's a little bit wet. He's probably going to be giving you that brake signal, especially with his tailwind. This is probably the hardest tailwind.
Have you been walking for 3 days?
Yeah. So, anyway, welcome to the top of the Eagle Tower. This line's 2,400 feet long, close to a half mile. If you look around, you can see like 4 power plants, 19 water towers, and 14 churches. You probably can't see their day. Anyway, this one's real fast. The wind's going good. You definitely break the 70 barrier. You can tell your friends.
Test one.
Test one. Just keep an eye on the brake signal down there. Because he could be breaking you early.
Good call.
That was a good call.
So just keep a heads up for that. Don't go hooking up just yet.
He just showed up on the end.
That's a long one. That's a long ways.
Yeah, he was there for a couple minutes.
He's gonna jump off.
All right, hang out right here for a second. I'm gonna come on. All right. Make sure that,
though. That was, it's weird.
I know. You were cooking it out.
Clear, Screaming Eagle 1, Screaming Eagle 1.
I'm doing that other one next.
Yeah?
Yep.